Good morning and welcome to a very warm North Carolina and a huge hello from the 2018 FEI World Equestrian Games. We're based here in the Johnson Controls Reining Arena for day one of one of the hottest competitions we have ever seen in the global sport of reining. Today it's about the team competition and the individual qualifiers to go into the 2 days of the individual medals over the next 3 days. Today, 63 competitors will come forward, 21 nations included, more nations than we've ever seen in an international reining competition ever before. 12 of the nations have teams here competing for the medals today. That will be decided at about 9:30 this evening, local time, here in North Carolina, United States of America. This fabulous arena, purpose-built by the Tryon International Equestrian Center, is absolutely beautiful. Everybody's raving about it, and we have no less than 18 of the top 20 reiners in the FEI global rankings. Well, I'm Phil Gazala. I'm here at the edge of the arena in what's got to be said, the best seats in the house. And alongside me is trainer, internationally renowned reining trainer, Peter Kyle. Pete, great to have you back. You joined us in France. Thank you very much for joining us here again.
Well, thanks, Phil, for having me back. We really enjoyed it and had a great reining in France at the World Equestrian Games there, and we're looking for an even better competition here in this fabulous Tryon International facility. And it's a beautiful morning here in Tryon. Even if you're watching the weather channels, they're telling you something different, I think. But right now it's a great day, and we're fortunate to be here and in this really nice indoor arena that it does not matter what the weather is outside. So everybody needs to come in and join us.
Well, here at the World Equestrian Games today, we've got the endurance, and we've also got the dressage starting. And of course, they're outside, so we're protected in here, Pete.
It is very nice. And I tell you, we're about to get it hot, like you said, on these competitions. They're about getting ready to start, and we have a lot of great riders and great horses from all over. Reining has become such a global event, and it's going to be very competitive for this team competition today.
Well, we've got 30 riders coming for the first session. That'll end at about 12:30 local time, and then we start again at 4 o'clock. Let's just have a look at all the starters. We get underway with Manuel Cortese for Italy, world ranked number one. Eric Laporte will be coming in second, currently in the number one position in the global rankings. Then the Team USA bidding to retain their title, and the first of their four riders there, Gary Deary, with the heavy duty checks. And as you can see, no more nations than ever before. 21 nations. Quite unbelievable, Pete, that so many nations now are competing at this level of this sport.
It truly is, and that's it. It's the level of this sport right here. This is the best of the best, and they are all that competitive around the world. You know, the United States used to be the leader in the sport of reining, but all of the European countries and South American countries, Brazil and Argentina, and all of them have really worked hard and trained hard and improved their horses, and they are all very competitive, and it's going to be a great event.
Well, that's the 63 competitors coming forward. Today is about the team medals, but it's also a qualifier for the individuals. The first 15 competitors today will qualify for the individual medals on Saturday, irrespective of the team results. So the first 15. Tomorrow, the next 20 after the first 15 go into a consolation day. But that's not just about wooden spoons, because the top five in that consolation competition tomorrow will also qualify for the big medals, the big individual medals on Saturday, making 20 in total. But today is about the team competition and the individual qualifiers. But Pete, Team USA defending title, reigning started in 2002 at the FEI World Equestrian Games. They've won gold medals every time. But you've got some competition from Europe.
Oh, yes, for sure. Like I say, we've won every gold medal since we've started reigning at the World Equestrian Games. And this is the most competitive it's going to be with the other teams. Like I say, they have globally caught up and are excellent riders and have some beautiful horses. And so I think it's going to be a lot of fun today to see how this falls out, because there's quite a few great teams that will be able to vie for the gold medal. It's just not one or two. It's five or six teams that have a real shot at it.
That's never been so open, which makes the sport, of course, much more interesting globally. We all like to win, but if you haven't got domination, what you've got is excitement. And that's what we're going to bring you here from the Tryon International Equestrian Center here, from this purpose-built, beautiful arena. And we just got our first of the 63 competitors coming into the arena. World number 11 in the FEI rankings for Italy, and a member of the Italian team, one of those favorites that Pete has been talking about, Manuel Cortesi with PC Sildarina for me. Pete, pattern eight today, is that right?
Pattern eight, yes. This pattern is a really nice pattern. They'll come into the middle of the arena, as you're seeing Manuel do, stop, and they're going to execute four spins to the left and then four spins to the right. That means turn around, so they'll do that four times each way. Okay, that's a very good start. Just a real correct set of turnarounds right there. See how that horse kept its hind foot in a good spot, and it stayed right in the same spot as it turned, doing the same turn again the other direction. Just real solid. Probably just zeros on each. Real correct means like a zero. And then if you get a plus half or a plus one, that's where you've stepped that game up and you've made it a better maneuver. And it can go the other way to a minus half, to a minus one.
So a zero, actually the maneuver is correct. It's just not exceptional or not bad.
Correct. That's exactly it. It's a good average would be what you'd want to say. It's a good average maneuver. So that gives you a little idea about the scoring system. And here on the circles, what we're going to watch today is they do a large, fast circle, which he takes right off, adds speed, and uses the full size of the arena, which it's a really nice big arena, and then comes back to a small slow. He executed a very nice small slow. The horse came right back to him, willing and guiding. This is better than average. This is good right here. He's doing a really nice set of circles.
What are you liking about it, Pete? The horse is not being
he's willfully guiding that
exactly.
Horse, you see how Manuel's just got his hand right forward. That horse is just staying between those reins. That horse isn't guessing which way to go. He's following Manuel's cues and going straight forward and right around, and just makes it look easy. Looks like I could, and you and I could both do this, and it's not as easy as Manuel's making it look right there. And again, came back to an extremely nice small slow, showed great difference in the speed. See how he's running fast now, and he had come down to that small slow effortlessly. So excelling really well right here in his circles. And that's a lead change. They switched from that left lead, they were in that left circle, switched leads and legs, and now he's in the right lead and going to come down for the exciting part of the reining is our big stops.
That's what you're famous for, and that's what we all love.
And you want to build that up and increase a lot of speed and get down in. Oh my goodness, how about that, folks, huh? Very nice. And that, Phil, that's exactly what you want to see. You want to see that horse getting in the ground with both hind legs and pushing really strong and staying free on that front end, so it can go farther. If it got real stiff with its front legs, it would stop real quick. But with him, watch these hind legs go in the ground and then the front feet keep working. See how that keeps going?
Yeah,
that allows
sure.
him to keep sliding along. And then they want to roll back and get right back out over the same tracks that they came down. He's given us a very good pattern to start the competition with.
Just on the scoring, we have five judges around the arena, just three, and they drop the best and the worst of those scores. Is that correct?
Correct. They'll drop the high score and they'll drop the low score and take the other three scores. And you start off like in that 70 is your average score. So it depends on your pluses and minus. So your average score would be 210. And if you were good, it'll go above a 210 score.
We're underway here in North Carolina for day one of the FEI Reigning World Championship. 63 competitors and the first for Team Italy, Manuel Cordesi, has just completed his routine. And what a fabulous start, Pete.
It was a great start. Manuel, like I said, gave us an extremely solid pattern, hit every maneuver, did not have any penalties, was very positive run. I'm looking for a nice score here to start us off.
Just waiting for the scores. As we just mentioned, there are five judges around the arena, and they take away the best and the worst score, leaving the total of the three median scores to give us the final score. Riders have been saying over the last 2 days, they've been here for two or three days warming up, but that the surface is absolutely brilliant.
As you can see, that ground was very nice, you know, and made it perfect. He ran hard in the circles, was able to hold his feet really well, and then same thing in stops. I mean, it was very easy for him to stop.
He's gone 221, Pete.
There you go. That's a really high score. That's a very good start right there for Manuel.
And a good start for Team Italy.
A great start for Team Italy, yes.
So he's that 21. That's that would what they're saying is that was a perfect routine. Nothing better than average.
Yeah, no, it was really good. He wound up marking scores of 73s and 74s by the five judges, and so the average those all together, and that's where you come up with the 221. And like a 70 is your average score, so each judge went up a lot with that from there.
Of course, average 210. Now, for France.
Here's Eric Laporta, and he's from France. He's actually living out in the United States in California and has a training business out there and does quite well here in the States showing. His first turnaround was really good. You could see the horse turn very fast, but he stopped a little short of getting dead straight on the middle like he is right now. And so that's a penalty half. So he's starting off with a penalty half and then that maneuver plus half to zero. This horse is extremely talented, though. He can make up those maneuvers.
And would Eric be aware of that?
Yes, Eric's very aware. The riders are very aware of when they make a little mistake. And sometimes they know they have to block that out of their mind and concentrate on the next maneuver and make it as good as they can to gain that speed, gain that position back up again and try and get a better score. He's come down to a nice small slow again. You can see the change in the speed and a little bigger circle than Manuel, but still nice size for this arena. Stepping right forward, this horse is doing the same, just staying right between his reins right there, coming right through, right there in the middle of the arena. You see, that's where you want to do.
Good change.
Good change, clean with his feet there, no penalties at all that direction. And everything comes right back to the center of the arena. So you want to be precise in your markings, just like that. Here he is, right there where he started. He came back through and executed the small, slow circle again. Very good job, Eric. And here he's really asking his horse. They're all riding big right now. They know they want to do well for their team. Even though they're the first riders out, they want to get a really good score for their team and get their team kicked off on a good note. And then all the other members hopefully can just continue to step and build on it.
And Pete, four members of team, best three scores count. One or two nations just have the three competitors. So they've all got to count.
They've all got to count in that position, yeah. And on that stop, he just missed it as he entered the stop just a little bit and then got in the ground and finished. So that won't receive high marks, okay, from the judges on that particular stop. Again, we have a total of seven maneuvers here that they're scoring. So one maneuver doesn't hurt you. You just have to continue to make every maneuver count, just like Manuel did. Eric's setting him up for the rundown. He's building him up really good. and a nice stop again. Just didn't quite hold that ground well enough at the very first part, but really got in and went really long. Eric's doing a very nice job of showing this horse as well. We're off to the kind of competition we thought we'd be, Phil. It's going to be a quality competition all day long.
Eric Laporte for France, Holier Than Thou, ranked world number one in the FEI rankings.
Oh, there, that's his best stop. I mean, what a nice stop. And then backs his horse up, and see how willing that horse gives his face and backs right up really good. That's a great finish there, and that's what you want.
And that's a great start for Team France. So Italy and France have got us underway here at the FEI World Equestrian Games here in Tryon, North Carolina, day one of the FEI reigning individual and team competition. 12 teams, 12 nations with teams, and already Pete, the two riders that we've seen is just showing us, as you mentioned, the level of the sport that we've got.
Yes, and he marks a 2.16. So that's a good score to get him. It's on the positive side. It's like a 72 to where Manuel was 73 and 74 is a little better. Like I say, he was really solid. He had a little penalty there on that first turn. Cost him actually a point and a half because it's a half a point per judge. So that would have been a 17 and a half. So you see how the penalties can really affect you quickly. So you definitely want to stay out of that penalty box, you know. And you can get a penalty in the turns or in the lead changes coming out of that rollback. So those areas are critical that you get them in and out right.
First team member for the Netherlands, Michael Sandick with Wimpy's Snow Gun by Wimpy's Little Step. Michael Sandick just inside the top 50 in the world.
This is a much nicer turnaround to the right, and every horse is just like us. They have a right side and a left side, and they were able to do one direction a little easier than the other. And obviously this horse was very right-sided, had a good turn to the left, no penalties, but was a good turn to the right. Nice set of circles, horse looks very comfortable, just guiding and waiting. Comes back really nice to his when Michael picked up there, just very soft, gave, had that big transition in speed that we like. This is no surprise that this horse is good. It's by Wimpy's Little Step, who is one of our all-time reigning sires, and then out of a great mare, Snow Gun, had a great career herself. So this horse has the pedigree to be a good one, and obviously is. Very nice horse. And she's a mare. And so, you know, the mares, you know, sometimes they say they're not quite as physical as the stallions, but anymore our mares have become as physical and do really well. We have quite a few mares that have won over 100,000 in NRHA earnings, which is a lot of money. Of course, leaned on him just a little bit right there in that circle, so that's going to take that circle down just a hair, where the other horses you saw really stayed right with that rider. This horse anticipated going the other direction a little early. You can see him kind of holding him up there, and then got a very clean change, so that'll hurt Michael a little bit, but not much. It'll be all right. He needs to come down here and really nail these three stops real big. And you want them to run really straight. You see that horse change leads a little bit to the left lead running. That means he's dropped his shoulder just a little there, but you couldn't really tell. But it does. That's not a penalty. It's good in that once he's in that straight line. Got in the ground very well, had a very nice stop and a good rollback. Oh, yeah.
That looked better, Pete.
That was much better, Phil. That was very good right there. That's a plus maneuver. He's making up ground like we said he needed to. Oh, again, you see how all these horses are very broke, right in control, right there for all the horses, I mean, for the rider's commands. Again, another good increase, good stop. Nice backup right there, very willingly backing up. Super, super horse. Good start right here again.
And that's a great start for Michael Sandick, Wimpy's Snow Gun. For the Netherlands. The Netherlands, one of the European teams looking to be the first European team to take this title of the team gold medalists at the FEI World Equestrian Games.
The Netherlands have a very good team. They've got some very veteran riders as well, and so they're going to do good.
And the score for Michael Sandick, 217.5. The current score is 72.5. A couple of 372.5 in the scores.
Yeah, that's a great start again. I mean, right now you're seeing just one good run, one good start right after another. So that's really the way we like to see it, and it's the kind of competition we thought we were going to see.
And now we go to one of the nations that are really on the tails of the U.S. title. That's what they want, and that's what they're here for. Belgium, Dries Verscheren with Smart and Sparkin.
Yes, Belgium has won silver at the last two World Equestrian Games, and so they are really wanting to knock the USA off of that gold medal. And they have the riders and the horses to be able to do that. This is a really, really talented stallion right here. That's by AQHA Hall of Fame and NRHA Hall of Fame member Smart Chicolina. He's been a great sire, and this horse has had a very successful campaign over in Europe. He's a really, really talented horse. Boy, started off really nice, super fast turns, probably our best turns to start with. Got just a little bit out of cadence there at the end, going to lower that score from like a big plus one to maybe a plus half, but still a positive maneuver. Oh, and he stepped out of that maneuver just a little bit right there, and so that's going to hurt him. That'll take it, and then he made up for it. He got right back into the turn and completed the turn well, so he's good, solid. Zero on that turn because of that step out. That's going to hurt him. But again, it wasn't real bad, so he should be able to try and make some more up. This horse is very physical horse. He can do things really, really well. So I think he can make up a lot of ground here. Again, nice set of circles. Showing that controls, change of speed. Very good moving horse, very nice loper, very relaxed about everything. That's the thing about these quarter horses is they're so great-minded, you know, that they can go really fast and then come down really slow and turn fast, run and stop, and then just lope off and say, okay, that's no problem. Want me to go fast? Fine. You want me to go slow? It's good. You saw when he came out of the small, slow circle, this horse kind of anticipated maybe going the other direction as well, so that'll hurt that circle a little bit. Good lead change and really asking him in this set of circles here.
And what sort of age are the horses to get to this level, Pete?
You know, FEI requires them to be at least 7 years old, so a lot of them competing here today are 7 and 8, but we have several that are 10, 11, 12 years old. They have good longevity to them and very competitive horses for a long time.
We're watching the first of the four members of the Belgian team. Good change.
Good change. Made a really nice set of circles that direction. Should easily plus that maneuver on that side of the arena. Add to his score. Again, another positive run here. We're seeing just one good run after another here to start with. He kind of feathered into that ground just a little bit getting into it, but really went on, pushed on in there and got in that ground really strong. Extremely nice horse here. This stallion's shown a lot. He's won a lot, and he's still just trying his heart out here to do all he can do for his rider. There he's going. He's building that speed up so you get that good momentum to be able to slide. And that was a really good stop right there, Phil. You really like that. Belgium teammates were hollering for that one as well.
They still are.
Okay, he wants to get one more big finish here. He had a couple of little bobbles that he's making up ground on, so he wants to finish it out really strong, leave a positive impression in those judges' minds. Like I say, this horse is very talented and stops really big. So that's another good start. That's a good start for Team Belgium. As you can see, they're happy about it as well.
So the first team member for Belgium, Dries Verschuren with Smart and Sparking, waiting for their scores. We've had three competitors to start, and what to start it has been here at the FEI reigning day one here at the World Equestrian Games. Manuel Cortesi for Italy came us into the arena and blew us away at 9 a.m. this morning with a score of 221. He had 374s and 273s. Eric Laporte, world number one for France, he put a score on the board of 216, and Mikael Sandic, first team member for the Netherlands, 217.5, and just gone into second place, 219.5, a score hit by Dries Verschuren, first of the team members for Belgium. And Belgium, as Pete is alongside me, Pete Carl said, they're here to get that gold medal. They've been second over the last twice at the last two World Equestrian Games, and they want to topple the USA, but they are not. They've got a lot of work to do. They're not on their own, because this is a very, very tough competition. The first for the Brazilian team, Marcela Almeida da Silva with Mahogany Whiz by Topsail Whiz, a 10-year-old man for Brazil.
Yeah, that was a great start for Team Belgium for sure. Solid run right there, and they're going to make it very difficult for everybody here competing. This is another team from South America that has a great chance at the gold. They have a very strong team, a great group of horses and riders. Brazil is a country that they're very agricultural, and they have an extreme amount of horsemanships down there in all parts. Of course, as you know, in the PBR up here, they dominate our PBR in the bull riding and stuff. So it's a country that is to be reckoned with.
Now, he didn't stop quite square to us. Is that a problem?
Yeah, no, he actually was just a little bit off, but you're allowed one step. And so I think he was okay. I don't think he have a penalty, and he turned really fast. Now, he's lost his step. You see how those front feet weren't quite as smooth, and they were hopping up and down? That loses your cadence. So that's not a positive turn there. His first turn was an exceptional turn. It was very good. A lot of speed and real correct. Again, a very nice mare right here. This mare's had a lot of success here in the States, showing in the NRHA events. By our legendary Topsail Whiz horse, who's our all-time leading sire of reigning horses. Marcelo's doing a nice job right there, had good speed, came down real slow. Wants to get back to the center, did a great job. Got right back through that center of the arena. If you're off a little bit, Phil, that's going to hurt this maneuvers. You know, they take in consideration how the horse guides, how fast it goes, how it slows down, and the accuracy of these circles throughout the whole arena and also through the middle of the arena. A good lead change right there as well, and continues it right with that speed right into the next circle. Good there. Again, nice transition. Almost a little slow there, motion-wise. You know, I'd like to see that low continue to keep that cadence a little cleaner, but it's not a penalty and won't deduct anything at all. It's still good.
But Pete, this is looking like a very good start for Brazil. I mean, just, you know, I'm not as familiar with this sport, obviously, I mean, like you guys, but this is already, you can see it's very, very neat.
Yes, it is. This is a very nice horse, and Manuel's doing a good job of getting it. Marcelo's getting a good job of getting it shown, and this will be a good start for him. He finishes out real strong here. Really nice big increase. Oh, good stop there. Kind of hung that left front foot with its hind foot just a little and made it bend over, but it stayed in the stop good and won't be a problem. Just took away from it being an excellent stop. Very nice row back. Comes up around the arena. You want to get straight. You want to stay off the middle of the arena, but yet get down there to really good dirt. Good roll back. Very nice start right there. Again, another good stop.
Marcello, who's not short of support, that's for sure, from the side of the arena here.
That is for sure. Here he goes, wanting to get that big finish. And does just that. They're all doing a great job of showing here today, which we expected, and it's going to be just a fabulous day of raining here in the arena at the Trion International Arena.
And that's Brazil complete the first of their team competitors. They do have an individual here as well. Five competitors from Brazil taking part here at the 2018 FEI World Equestrian Games. We're on day one of the reigning. Manuel Cortese for Italy. He was the first competitor in. He set a very high bar with 221. It looks like Marcello Almeida da Silva on 216 for the first of the four competitors for Brazil. 216 level score with the first competitor for France, world number one, Eric Laporte. He also had a 216.
Yeah, nice deal. He had a couple of little bobbles in there that cost him, and it just takes that to take it from a 219 to a 216, and that's a huge difference in your scoring right there.
We now go to the first of the individuals to compete. Of course, it's a very important competition. It's about team medals, but it's also about qualification for the individual final on Saturday. For Morocco, Khalid El Kounsi with the 10-year-old Masterful by Master Snapper, sole competitor for Morocco.
It's so great to see so many different countries competing here in Morocco. I mean, it's just great. Great to have him here competing, and hopefully he'll gain some more members in his country to where they can eventually build up to having a team. He does a great job of riding and showing this horse. I saw him at the last World Equestrian Games, and he's been working extremely hard since then to improve and get better, and he definitely has. Real good start right there. Just a very nice turnaround, real correct, no penalties to it, good position on him.
Actually, Pete, just talking about Morocco, because the horse sports in Morocco are growing like they are in every other country. They have some good show jumpers. They've got good dressage riders. They have a fabulous equestrian center just outside the capital of Morocco, Rabat. It's like a lot of these nations. It won't be long. A few years' time, they'll be going to be bringing the team.
Exactly correct. And the Western sport there is really taking hold. It's been more of an English-driven country, and these Western people are starting to really enjoy it there, enjoy the Western saddle and being able to show these quarter horses. And he had a super, super nice turn to the right. It was very nice. And doing a good job in a circle here. Again, good control, makes it look easy. That's what you're always wanting. If it looks easy, that's what you want. He leaned out there just a little. It's not a big maneuver deduction, but just a little bit of a deduction there in the back of the judge's mind. He could have just a titch more speed, but sometimes you know your horses, and you know where they're best at their speed, and you have to show them in their maneuver that fits them the best. good lead change. He kind of dropped that shoulder in a little bit. You see, he cut inside that circle from where the other riders were. So the circle's not quite as precise. So a few just little things here that add up on the score. And it's the finer details in this kind of competition that will hurt you. So not only do you have to be a great rider and a great horse, you have to be a great showman and be able to hit all of the maneuvers correctly.
Watching Khaled El Kumsi for Morocco individual.
Doing a great job. I mean, he has improved a lot. His horse is very nice horse. Running a better set of circles this direction. Completes his change. Having a penalty free run here, getting along really well. Come around that corner, get them straight, and you want them to run straight down through there to this stop. If a horse is running straight, then they're able to use their body a lot better and get in that ground just like he did and then be able to come back out of it. If he's running a little crooked, like leaning to the left or leaning to the right, that's the way that stop's gonna go. So far, we've seen all these horses run just like they're supposed to, really straight, really correct, and they haven't leaned any and put that weight more on one leg than the other. You want them stopping on both of those hind legs behind really strong, and that's where he's going. He's going to build him up here again for that next stop. Good. Very nice stop. Again, not quite the speed that some of the other competitors have had, so again, without that lack of speed, you cannot get a bigger stop. You know, you need more speed to be able to really slide faster, but he is running a very correct, clean pattern here and doing a good job. And hopefully this is going to be enough to get him in the individuals. I'd love to see him be competing on Saturday night in the individuals for a medal. Okay, little stiff there in the front end, as you saw him bounce just a little, but I mean a great solid run for him. He should be extremely happy with that. He's very good. Yeah, he's happy.
Showing his appreciation, Khaled El Kumsi for Morocco. With Masterful, sole representative for Morocco, looking to get into that top 20, not that top final, well, the top 20 over the next 2 days for the big final, the individual final on Saturday here in Tryon. A very happy man compete, and he's scored 210, 70.5, 71 from judge at one, then 210. Yeah, that's the total score for Khaled El Kumsi and Masterful for Morocco.
Yeah, that was just a really nice, correct run all the way through it, and that's just what they gave him credit for. And that's a good score for him, a nice score, and hopefully, if it doesn't get him in the top 15, it'll hopefully get him into that next group of 20 horses competing tomorrow for that top five.
So. And there are the scores on the screen so far to show you that Italy, first team member, way out in front with an incredible 2:21. Belgium on his heels. They're two of the favorites. Now we're going to go into the first drag, and we'll just come off air for a few moments, but we'll be right back with the rider number 7. That'll be for Mexico, Mariana Vasquez Rodriguez, in about 5 minutes' time. Join us then. We'll be right back.
Thank you. Well, you can see the Dragmaster Drag wrapping up its work here as we prepare to move along to the order here. And we'll have a lineup coming up next from Mexico in just a few. Goodness, making their way back to their positions, of course, around the show pen. We'll get another thank Laura Jean, proud to be the official partner and timekeeper of the FBI World Equestrian Games, and to present the official watch of the event, a model of the record collection. You can discover this line as well as many others at Laura Jean's boutique, located in the heart of the Legends Plaza. We also want to thank Adrian Hell, the best for the Carolinas. Life and health go hand in hand, arm in arm, and side by side. That's why every month, nearly a million people come to Atrium Health, because our doctors...
Welcome back to the FEI reigning competition at the 2018 FEI World Equestrian Games here in Tryon, North Carolina, United States. We've had the first six of the 63 competitors competing today, and already this is the team competition, and already, even just after six competitors, we can see how tight that this competition is going to be. 21 nations taking part here for the 3 days, 12 of those nations fielding teams, and it's not going to be dominated by USA as that we have been used to seeing over the last few FEI World Equestrian Games. I'm Phil Gazzala. I'm joined with Pete Carl alongside me. Pete, we've had a great start. Manuel Cortese, he was the first to go for Italy. He put a score on the board of 221. That's a very good start.
It's a very good start. Manuel did a great job for us, as did all the other exhibitors here so far this morning. It's a fabulous competition, and it's just going to continue to get higher scores as we go all day long. I think we have really some great, great horses and riders coming forth, as this young lady right here from Mexico.
Mariana Vasquez Rodriguez with Jack's Lil Spook, 11-year-old by Smart Spook Stallion.
Mariana is one of two competitors that I know of here that are 19 years old. So that is very young to be on this level of competition, and that tells you the quality of athlete that they are and the showman that they are. She is a very good competitor. She lives just right outside of Chicago and competes all over the United States and loves the game. Her and her dad, both her dad is on the team as well, and very competitive. They win a lot of big reinings all over the world and all throughout the United States. So I look for them to do a really good job here. Not quite her best turn. I know she would like it to be a little better than it was. He lost his cadence just a little bit and lost his step. This is much better this way. Came right back, completed a very good turn to the right. Dead center on the stop, so she's off to an okay start right here. Beautiful Palomino Stallion by Smart Spook, which is one of our top stallion, reigning stallions. He's also a son of Smart Chicolina, so carrying on the bloodlines of the great reigning horses. Okay, she didn't come back to the middle quite as smoothly as the other horses, but still showing a good transition in the speed. He's a little more of a forward horse, meaning he's got a big stride, and he really strides out well. And she's running a very nice big set of circles here. Probably going to wind up with a zero in this circle. Just cuts in. See how she's cutting that one side of the circle off a little bit and didn't round it quite as smooth. He's just cutting into these circles just a little bit with his shoulder, just dropping in.
That's made me think, Pete, you mentioned this is a lovely big arena. Do you don't have a set size? Do you like they might have in dressage? Do you have a set size of arena?
No, the sport of reining doesn't. It's just whatever size arena that they have at the competitions, you know. A bigger, wider arena makes it a lot easier for these horses to run these big circles. They can really ask for more speed that way. A tighter, smaller arena, like a dressage arena, makes it very difficult to get much speed in your circle. So a little bigger arena really enables them to get up and go. She lost her hat there, which is not a penalty or anything.
I was just going to ask that question, Pete.
Yeah, but she sure wasn't happy. No cowboy or cowgirl wants to lose their hat when they're out there riding, that's for sure. There's her hat there on the ground. She did not quite nail that stop as aggressive as the other horses. You saw, if you watched his hind feet, they didn't stay in that ground and hold the ground as well as we would want. This horse is very capable of stopping big. He just missed that maneuver a little bit. And again, the same thing there. Just didn't quite keep in the ground as well as she would want him to do, what he's really capable of doing. She wants to come around here and try and give that nice last stop. You see he's kind of had his head cocked out on that one run down a little bit, and that affects it. Like I say, you want that body straight. Like, he's a lot straighter there. A little better stop there. She's going to be happy to have finish up like that. Good job.
That completes the routine for rider number one of the Mexican team, Mariana Vasquez Rodriguez, with Jack's Lil Spook.
Scores coming in here for Mariana Vasquez and Jacksonville Spook will be a 206.
Mexico post a 206 for rider number one for Mexico. Mariana Vasquez Rodriguez, 206.
So those are your scores for, again, our rider.
You say she's a young rider, just 19 years old?
Yes, and she is going to have a bright future in front of her. Like I say, she's already been very successful, and you have to be that to be able to even qualify to make your team to come here. And she, you'll see plenty more of her in the future.
Well, Germany are fielding a team here, but this lady riding for Germany is here as their sole individual, Maria Theresia Till, with Arc Captain, stallion by Master Snapper. For Germany, Maria Theresa Till, Arc Captain, riding as an individual.
Yeah, and so what she's trying to do as an individual is try to, again, get in that top 20, so then she'll be able to compete on Saturday night. So, very nice start to the right turn here, and finished real good.
A better finish to the left turn.
Correct. You are correct. Phil, before long, you will not need me here. You're going to become an expert, and you'll just tell me to leave, and I'll just have to go sit in the stands like all the other people, spectators.
Pete,
enjoy the raining.
Pete, you're going nowhere. Hurricane or no hurricane, you're going nowhere.
She's doing a very nice job here for Team Germany, representing them. Germany's another country that has excelled in reining. They've got a very great group of talented riders and trainers and horsemen and horsewomen, and they really do a great job in Germany. They're a very big country, and they have a lot of shows, very successful shows, and everybody goes to Germany and shows and enjoy it. It's a lot of fun to be with the Germans. Had a little rough lead change there.
Yeah, it just took her a bit of time, didn't it?
Yeah, it did. She was out of that box. Once you're out of that middle, you're allowed one stride, then it turns into a penalty. And so she was probably in that penalty one spot, which, again, is hard to make up. When you have a penalty one, then you've got to have a couple of big pluses to get it back up to just being a zero. So you don't want to get in that penalty box if possible. She's trying to make up for it a little bit here in this set of circles. Coming through for the lead change and nails this one. Really good there. She's going to want to have to get these stops because that'll help her score go up a lot, and she's needing a little bump on that. So she's going to want that score.
One technical question for you, Pete. She's riding with a right hand, as I think they all have. Can you ride with the right or a left, or does it have to be the right?
You can ride with the right or the left, yes. A lot of riders actually ride with the left hand just because of the old days of originally when you started, you were right-handed. You would carry your sword or your whatever in your right hand. If you're a cowboy, you'd right-handed.
Lasso, I guess.
You'd have your rope, you know.
Your rope, yeah.
Yep. So, but in this competition, it's not about that. You're not carrying anything extra, so you can ride with either hand that you want. Some people are just a lot more comfortable with that. Very nice stop. Good job, girl. Very good. Building that speed up, really running fast. Well, she didn't lose her hat. She almost did. She has it safety pinned on, obviously, there with some bobby pins to kind of stay on a little better. And finished with a really good stop. Didn't let that interfere with her. And good job.
And that completes the routine for the individual riding for Germany, Maria Theresia Till, with our captain. Her scores starting to come through. And I've just heard the arena announcer say 208, looking at our screens. Yes, indeed. Into seventh place at the moment, Maria Theresia Till with a score of 208.
Yeah, so I think it's probably not going to get her up into that top 15 or even to maybe that next 20 with that score there. But she's gave a very good ride and just had a couple little bobbles that sure keeps you out of there.
Now for Australia, ranked 50th in the world in the FEI Global Rankings, Robin Schiller with Smart Like Steady. 14-year-old. Gelding by Steady Tradition.
Yeah, and here's an older horse that you'll see will do an excellent job. This is a very nice horse. Robin is originally from the U.S. She's married an Australian trainer. They live here in the United States. She's representing Team Australia and will do an excellent job for them. She's a very good competitor. She's won world titles here in the United States. Really good rider. As you can see, this horse just two solid turns right there. Very nice. And he will do this entire pattern that way. He will just stay really consistent and be very nice. I'm looking for Robin to put up a pretty darn good score here for him. Very good speed. Coming back right there in the middle of the arena. Very good. Having to help him just a little bit there. It's better if you can just kind of leave him alone and just let him do that small slow. Not a penalty, but just takes away a little bit. Robin's an excellent showman, and she knows how to show one. Gets back out in that big circle. Really correct right there.
He's done that before.
Yes. Came through there smoothly, for sure. Really like this set of circles here a lot better than the first set. Nice loose rein, not holding on to him. Picks up and he came back very nice. Making a little bit larger, small, slow than some of the other riders. But again, that's not a problem in this size arena. You can make that and be okay. Got him right back into that big, fast circle again. Really nice. Robin's come through, completes that change right there. Good shape for her rundowns and stops. This horse is really big stopper and She should be able to gain some ground here on this score, make it bigger. How about that feel? That was pretty, wasn't it? And she did a really good job of just picking that horse, making him build a little bit, weight, making him build a little bit more, and then finished with really good speed. So that was definitely a nice plus stop right there. Such a pretty horse. And again, here's a 14-year-old horse and just doing this job really very, very easy for him to do it and very willing to do it. Another good stop. Kind of slowed down just a little bit before the stop. Would like to see him keep running a little stronger to the end there, but he completed it well, got in that ground strong, and Robin got a good clean roll back out of it. She's going to try and make sure he gives her a real big finish right here. And does. Get a good backup, and Team Australia will be happy with that start right there. Good job, Robin.
What a great start for Team Australia. Happy team members in the crowds here at Triumph. Day one of the FEI reigning World Equestrian Games. It's all about the team medals today and qualification for the individuals, but tonight it will be distribution of the team medals. And that was a great start for Australia. We'll wait for the scores, and there it is, 280, exactly 218 for Australia. That puts them into third position.
Great job by Robin. What a super start for Team Australia. That's what you want. Good, solid score. She had a great ride. Kicked her right up there.
The best three scores for each team will carry through.
She'll be thrilled with that, I guarantee it. Her husband and her teammates are all going to like it as well. We'll get to see her husband compete a little later on here in the event as well. They're a good team, and
I think he was in Australia. I think he was in the team in 2014. In France.
Yes, that's correct. Yes. Here's a young man from Germany that is very experienced and extremely talented. One of their top riders there. Grisha is a great, great guy and an excellent competitor. He's capable of winning on any level. Anytime he walks in the arena, you have to be worried about what Grisha's going to do for you.
Just missed out of a medal as an individual at the last FEI World Equestrian Games in Normandy. As Pete says, for Germany, Grisha Ludwig and Ruth Lil Diamond.
Excellent turn there, very nice. Maybe just a little short, but I think he's okay. He's allowed one step under, and I think he'll be all right with that. If they line up that left front leg to the right hind leg as an NRHA judge, AQHA, FEI judge looking at it, that's what it does. Oh, beautiful set of turns out of the way. Big plus that direction. Easy plus half. Grisha's just like we thought, off to a good start.
Just looking at those spins again there, Pete, do you get dizzy when you do that on a horse?
You do the first few times you do it. You know, if I was to put you on one and you'd go out there, I guarantee you with that speed like that, you'd be holding on and then be a little dizzy. But these guys do it so much, you know, their equilibrium builds right up and the horse's equilibrium is outstanding. And so
I just noticed Grisha looking up in the air. I just wondered if that was partly to do with it or to stop him from getting dizzy.
Different riders have different, just like skaters that turn, you know, some will twist their head real quick, and some of our riders even do that just because of that, you know. Boy, what a nice little mare this is right here. He's getting along really well. Really pretty set of circles going. Good lead change. And continuing right through there. That's what you'd want to do. You have that speed of that one big circle, you change and keep going right through to the next set of circles. And see how he makes it look effortlessly. I mean, this little mare, she's just going right through it. Everything is really smooth and clean. Good job. Speeds right back up again.
Do you have references to the speed in the language you use in reining? I mean, do you say one's a gallop, one's a canter, or how do you refer to the different speeds?
Yeah, it's a lope is a slower one, and then the gallop is your faster one. Okay. You know? So you bet, just like all the other disciplines.
Sure.
That small slow is kind of just a nice soft lope. He's had a very very good run so far.
I get the feeling this is going to be good.
Oh, yeah. Very nice right there. Gets that row back real clean. Comes out very good. Yeah, he's going to be pushing Manuel here for the lead, I tell you, if he finishes these next two stops like that first one. This is exciting. This is what we expect for the rest of the reining, is continue to see him push that top envelope and get those higher scores going. Oh, excellent job. Good showman, yeah. Everybody's happy with that.
And I just noticed his rollback. He went right back on his tracks from when he came up, which we haven't seen every competitor do that, but he was spot on it.
He was spot on, and that's credit earning. That makes that score go up when you complete that rollback straight over and make it effortless like he did as well. Here he's building again for that finale. Makes a really nice long run down and finishes huge. I think this is going to be a really good score here. Very nice run. Expect nothing less from this young man than that right there.
And as we're hearing the crowd showing their appreciation to number 15 in the world, Grisha Ludwig for Germany. The best result we have seen so far today here in Tryon at the World Equestrian Games in the day one of the reining was 2:21, set by Manuel Cortese for Italy. Are we going to see? We have indeed got a new leader, 2:23.5, 2:23.5 from Grisha Ludwig for Germany. Pete, just tell me what you think of that.
That's exactly what we knew was coming up. He is a fabulous rider, great little mare, and just had no penalties, made everything look effortlessly, and just did a great, great run right there.
So, Germany. The first rider for the team. We've had an individual, of course. That was Maria Theresia Till looking for a place in the final on Saturday. But today's about the team competition. And Germany, Grisha Ludwig, puts them in the number one spot. Four riders for each team. Best three scores count. One or two teams have just three riders, so they'll all have to count. But what a start.
What a great start for Germany. And like I said before, they've got a strong team and they're going to vie for medals all the way here.
We now go to Austria. Markus Morowitz, ranked 28th in the FEI global rankings with the 7-year-old Gunner's Chic Magnet by Colonel Smoking Gun.
Another team that I think is going to be competing for medals here. They've got three really strong riders and nice horses, and I think Team Austria is always battling right there for a seat at the podium, and I expect no different out of this team this year. They've got some excellent horses with some phenomenal top riders of our reining industry.
Pete.
There we go.
It must be a great pleasure to you Native Americans, because this is your sport, but you don't, whilst it's competition, it must be a great pleasure for you, and you must be proud how all these other nations have picked up a sport which is part of your tradition and made it globally important.
It truly is. It's a lot of fun to be able to see our discipline go so global and everybody be so successful at it. It's a sport that everybody can do, and it's fun. It's really challenging sport. These guys are making it look a lot easier than what it is, just like some of the NBA players make basketball look pretty easy. Not all of them can run and jam the ball like some of those guys. In the same way here, these guys make this look simple. It's not as easy as it looks, but it is a fun sport that anyone can do and go compete at. And it is great to see it be so successful globally. He had a really good start on his first turn and had a very rough turnaround on his right turn. So that'll hurt him here, but he's making up on his circles. Completes that lead change and continues through there. Very nice horse here by one of our leading sires as well, Colonel Smoking Gun, better known as Gunners.
Gunners.
He's doing a fabulous job of showing him here, Marcus is.
Gunner Smoking Gun, is that a Palomino? Is that a...
No.
He's dark, is he?
Yeah, he's a chestnut.
A chestnut.
Yeah, with a little white on his face and legs, a lot of white on his legs. And his foes usually have a little white on them, quite a bit of color, so. Good lead change there for him. That horse happens to be registered with both AQHA and the American Paint Horse Association and throws quite a bit of paint horses, a lot of color with them, so. But they're all talented, very nice horses. Oh, really solid stop, just really in the ground. Didn't have that good rollback that we like. You know, that horse, as he came out, kind of hung his head there to the right a little bit. Wasn't quite as clean, so that's going to take that maneuver score down. There's a positive stop with not a strong rollback, so then you take all of that in consideration, the judges will on that one maneuver. He needs to keep finishing big here.
He needs a big score, Pete, because Austria have just the three competitors, so they don't have the opportunity of a discard score.
And that's the only thing that hurts them a little bit. It always is nice if you have a little bobble, just like he had, to have that next horse that can always bump you up and over. But they're counting on all three. The other two riders have really good horses and can sure make up a little ground if they have to.
But even the best can make mistakes, so which you don't have the opportunity to have that, as you say, that little barrier to protect you. But that completes the first of the three Austrians. Marcus Morawitz, Gunner Chic Magnet. Thirty competitors in the first session here at the Tryon International Equestrian Centre for day one of the FEI World Reining Competition, World Championships, the World Equestrian Games. And that is a very good score for Austria. 216.5 puts Marcus Morawitz in sixth place at the moment, but a good score posted for Team Austria from the first of their three competitors. 216.5.
Yeah, really solid run and just a couple of little maneuvers and he would have been a lot better off with a higher score there. That just those little things take away on this level. But I tell you what, a nice solid run. Marcus would be fairly happy with that as a whole. And so, Team Austria, which is a very talented team, off to a decent start there.
Well, United States defending champions know that the Europeans and the other nations around the world are snapping at their heels. This is the first run for the United States. Casey Deary with Heavy Duty Checks.
This is a really talented horse that has been shown by his owner a considerable amount. And she had great success, won a tremendous amount of money competing in all of our reinings here in the United States. Casey's jumped on and shown him and had really good success with him as well. So he's by a multi-world champion horse, New Checks to Cash. That's one of our great sires as well. And Casey is one of our really bright, young, aspiring trainers that has won our NRHA fraternity, won our AQHA world champions. Just a great family man and a good deal. Woo. Good start there by Casey, too, on both of his turnarounds. Very, very good start. Very happy for him there. And this horse has just been that, Phil. He's just been a solid camper. He is a horse that just continues to always be there for you, whether you're in the non-pro or in the open level here. He just steps up to whatever level you want him at, and he says, I can do it, you know. And he always is giving it, makes it easy.
And just a seven-year-old, though, for great for this competition. The youngest is available to be, or allowed to be here, which is very good.
That's correct, yes. Comes right back through that middle. No thought of going anywhere else. Like I said, very honest. Has shown a lot. Doesn't have any thoughts of taking advantage of his rider anywhere. Just comes through and continues to give him that good run. Got his lead changed nice. So far, Casey's every maneuver's been a plus maneuver for him. He'll need to keep it up. Team USA is going to have to count on every one of their riders really having a good, solid score. Again, good transition right there. We've seen some horses maybe run a little faster, but Casey knows this horse well, knows right where he's at. He's doing a good credit earning circle here. It'll easily be a plus half maneuver if he can complete his change correct, if not better. So, oh yeah, very good. He's hustling him right around here. Good job.
Now he's looking over his right. Is he just judging his positioning for the...
Yeah, he's already lining up where he's going to run and stop, checking, you know, where some of the other horses have stopped. He's going to move to a little different area, so he's not stopping in the same track. See how he's right out there in some ground where nobody else has been. Very nice. Ran long down past the arena down there. And that's a credit-earning deal to go a little farther like that and have that stop that big. So he's having a great run here, Casey is.
Hugely important moment for the United States. Gold medal holders looking to retain it. First of their four competitors in the team. Good rollback, Pete.
No, not as good. He horse kind of came up, anticipated a little bit, and raised his head up and got out of that rollback a little bit. So that's definitely going to hurt him, that stop. He didn't run to it quite as strong as he did the first stop. And with that rollback, that's going to hurt that maneuver. But he's got a lot of other positive maneuvers. He just needs to finish this last stop really, really big. And good, and get that back up. Atta boy. Solid run for him. I don't think it's going to be Grisha's run, but very, very good run.
A very good run for the United States, for the reigning champions. Casey Drury, with heavy-duty checks, completes run number one for the United States. And if you could hear the support around this arena here in Tryon, North Carolina, and into equal first place. Equal first place, United States go to 23.5.
Big run, like I say, he had some huge maneuvers, made up for that one error over there. A great start for Team USA, as we expect them to always do. And Casey and this horse both are seasoned showmen, so we expected nothing less from them.
Well, so at the end of the second six competitors before another drag time, we've got joint leaders Grisha Ludwig for Germany and Casey Drury for the United States, 223.5. Italy, of course, in third place, 221, and the rest bunching up behind them. But it's all about Germany and the United States. Early on in this competition, we're going to another drag time, which is when the tractors come in to smooth out this brilliant surface here in Tryon, in the reigning arena, just to smooth it out for the next six competitors. So we'll come off air for about 4 or 5 minutes before we go into the third session. The next competitor in will be for Brazil, Roberto Ju in Coachista. He'll be in next. Give us 4 or 5 minutes. Be right back.
It's for those seeking a horse that is not just one in a million, but rather a horse that comes once in a lifetime. For the world is full of horses, but you never see the same, paying twice. And we want you to find your horse. Horses Hired for Greatness, the American Paying Horse Association, is a proud official media partner, and the world's second largest equine breed association, registering more than a million horses in 59 United Nations and Territories since it was founded in 1962. Visit APHA.com to start your paint horse journey today. And now we'll be sending in the tractor to do its work, president of the pen, as we're continuing on with our Johnson Controls Sport Break here in the 2018 Triumph FBI World Equestrian Games. once again, as you can see up on the four-sided big screen there, you can download the Spectator Judging app. You can find that on the App Store or Google Play, depending on your personal mobile device.
Welcome back to the side of the arena here in Tryon, North Carolina, and we're here for session one of the FEI reining, taking place in the Johnson Controls reining arena. And what a beautiful purpose-built arena it is indeed. And that's what's happened so far. The team medal, it's a battle, and we've only had one rider from each team, because Germany, Ludwig for Germany, 223.5, level with United States on a similar score. Manuel Cortesi for Italy, 221 on their heels. And Belgium, one of the favourites for this competition, in fourth place at the moment. It's very early days. They're on 219.5. It's very early days indeed. My name is Phil Gazzala, and I've been fortunate enough to have one of reining's top men here in the US sitting alongside me in Pete Kyle. Pete, it's very early on in this competition, but already there's tension at the top of the leaderboard.
There really is. A lot of great runs, and like I say, we expect to see a lot more great runs, but this just shows you the depth of the sport of reining all the way around the world. I mean, there is a lot of talented horses and riders here both competing, and that's what we expect.
Well, we're going to go shortly. There he is indeed for Brazil, riding as an individual, not part of the Brazilian team. 12 nations have got teams here, but also some individual riders as well. And this is one of those individuals. Roberto Ju Inchosti with F5, Licurgo Tapajós.
And this is one of their horses from Brazil down there. They're very talented. This is a Criolla, and they are very talented horses, and they're very proud of their breeds down there in Brazil, and they brought him up to compete here. A very good horse.
Are they traditionally reining horses, the Criolla?
Yeah, they are big stoppers. I mean, they can really run and stop huge, and same as the quarter horses, very good-minded. How about this mane and forelock on this horse, huh?
I was just wondering.
I don't know if he can see where he's going.
That's exactly what I was going to say. Look at that. What a great shot.
It is beautiful. And, you know, there's five, each team can have five individuals, and four of them are on the team, and then your fifth one is that individual person, and that's what he is here. Very good start, very nice run. Good turnaround.
And if you've just joined us here on day one of the FEI reining here at the World Equestrian Games, it's patent eight used for the first session. The first two sessions this morning and this afternoon.
And in these patterns, they do, as you just saw, a couple of spins each way, and then they do a couple of circles each way, and then they do three big stops at the end. So horse has to be very talented and be very athletic to do all the different maneuvers that we ask them to do. Boy, oh boy, very nice start right here for him. This is a real nice horse. He's doing good. Really nice set of circles. A lot of speed, came back really smooth and clean. Very high quality lead change right there, right in the center. Team Brazil, like I say, they're very talented. They've got a lot of great riders, and this shows. This is their fifth person right here, and I don't think he's anybody's fifth person. I think he's a very talented young man.
Exactly, Pete. If this is the quality of the guy who's not been put in the team.
Yeah, exactly. He's doing a fabulous job here, and that's why he's here. Yeah. Okay, now he's come down to his stops, and I tell you what, he's had a very good pattern. Real clean everywhere. Come around here, let's see how he gets down this run down. You want to make that run down real smooth and just keep increasing it up there like that. To that big stop, oh boy. Get out of there, get out of there, very good. Want to watch that they don't trot behind when they come out of that. None of the other horses have. He was close. He was real quiet, but he was clean on it, so it's not a penalty.
You don't want them to trot coming out.
Do not
on the
want
turn them
trot. You want to pick that lope right
lope
up.
Straight
lope
up. Yeah.
Straight off. Yes. If they trot, that's a penalty. All right. Good roll back again. Got out of there very clean. Super run. This is fun right here. This is what it's all about, watching all the different riders from all around the world be able to do this and do it quite well.
That was a great start for Brazil, riding as an individual. Roberto Gil Inchosti with F5, Lisergo Tapajos.
How about that, boy, all the way from Brazil up here and just did a fabulous run right there. That's really exciting.
2:21, equal third position with Manuel Cortesi for Italy. The man, he's riding as an individual, he's not in the team, he's bidding to be in the top 15 today to qualify for the big individual final on Saturday. And Pete, 2:21, well, that'll find him in the top 15.
That'll find him in the top 15, I feel very strong about that. I mean, that's really a good run, excellent job. I'm so happy for him that he did such a good job, and his horse is a really nice little horse. What fun that is right there.
Start with a 70-point score every maneuver, gives him a chance to either do better or worse, depending on how exactly that 223.5. Richard Ludwig, Casey Deary, that's the top riders, Germany, United States, equal third, 221. Roberto Gil Inchosti, Manuel Cortesi, that's the level of the sport here at the World Equestrian Games on day one of the FEI reigning. Now for Italy. Pierluigi Giotto with Gun at the Gate, 10-year-old by Colonel Smoking Gun. By Gun up, and Italy already with a rider with 221 aboard. That was Manuel Cortesi. This is the second rider for the Italian team.
And again, a very loaded team here. This team's quite talented, and this is a really nice little mare right here. So I'm looking forward to seeing this run. Look how attractive this horse is, how the conformation is really correct. You know, just a beautiful mare right there. Really pretty little head and eye, and a beautiful big hip. Just a very nice American quarter horse right there. Ooh! Oh, man. That was a big turn, and then he just quite couldn't get that shutoff handle, so he had like a plus one turn, and looks like it's a penalty one maneuver, a penalty one on the shutoff there. Didn't get it stopped straight. And a lot of times, Phil, that's hard to do when you're going as fast as he was going right there, is to get him shut off like that. And you'll sometimes incur a little penalty, but with that risk, that's what you're doing. You're doing that gain and risk both ways. So he really put it out there on that first turn and had a solid turn the second way. Had definitely a plus maneuver the second way as well. Like I said, this is a nice mare, and sure enough, she just started off just like that. Just fun to watch these horses come in one after another and be able to do these maneuvers. Like I said, make it look real easy and simple for you. You know, that's what it's all about, is just being able to see that and have that fun of doing it and just riding it. These guys are doing a fabulous job.
Well, I have to just tell you, Pete, that I've just had a text message because people are listening from all over the world, and I asked you if Gunner was a Palomino earlier. You corrected me and said it was a chestnut. So my daughter in the UK has now sent me a photograph, look on my phone, of
Gunner. That's him.
Of Gunner.
Big bald face and four white socks. He's a really pretty horse. That's.
He also put a rude comment that I got it wrong, so I won't repeat that on air, though.
That's what family does, is correct us, isn't it? Here, he's continuing to have a really solid run. Nice lead change. Now come down for these three big stops.
Very important run for Italy. Second member of their quartet. Best three scores count. They've got a good one in the bag. But they want another one.
And he's giving them that right there. Boy, very nice long run down. Used the whole length of the arena. And then that little mare just got right in that ground real soft and easy and just pushed right through there. Great roll back. He's just doing a great job again for his team here. And they're all going to be happy. He just needs two more like that, and he'll be extremely happy. Another good one, another very nice stop. Just a little bracing in that front end, but not bad at all. Very credit earning.
I was going to ask you about that, because I think I spotted that.
Yeah, just you can see those legs get a little stiff, and when they do, it kind of bumps them up. It didn't bump her out of the stop. But it kind of just, her front end came up a little bit. And that's a little rough on you if you're the rider there. But she's still really good. And very nice finish right there. What a great run.
Is there a set amount of steps that you should back up on? Is
it? No, you know, you want to go at least far enough that you can show a good backup, you know, 10, 15 steps, something like that. And if you go a little farther, it's okay. But you want to be able to show that you've got a good backup. They'll back off of that bridle.
And that's completed pattern 8 for rider number 2 for Italy.
That's going to put their team in a real solid position, I'm telling you, for the start of it. Both of their riders, really good, solid runs. They're both be very excited with it.
So all of a sudden we're now at the point of this competition here in Tryon, the team competition, team medals that will be decided tonight. We're at the position where we've got a second team member with a score, and we start to get an idea of how this competition is going to play out over the next 8 or 9 hours. And that's 218 into sixth place, 218, 218 for Pierluigio Chiodo for Italy.
Yeah, again, really solid run right there. So that is really a good deal for their team. They have two solid scores on the board, and that's what it's all about. Gives their team a 4:39. That gives everybody something to shoot at, I'll tell you.
Now for France, Glenn Arthur Estevel, coded N Karma. 7-year-old gelding by electric code. First rider for France, world number 1. Eric Laporte posted a 2:16, and that's currently in 10th equal place.
Oh, dadgum. Glenn is a great young trainer, training here in the United States, like say from France. He's an extremely nice young man. He was a little short on that first turnaround right there. This is a very talented horse. Been very successful as well. And he came back and had a really good right turn. He'll sure have a penalty half on that first set of turns. And so, again, anytime you get that penalty, you've got to have some really strong maneuvers to make that score up and take it back up. So you hate that. But Glenn's a really good showman. He's a young man, 24 years old. I mean, he's just really, really starting to get into his prime. Going to be a very successful trainer. Nice set of circles. good speed, good control, good accuracy, plus maneuver. That's what it all equals up to. That's what you want to do. Really pretty gilding here by Electric Code. A stallion that went over 200,000 with Jared LeClaire. He's really been a great producing young sire coming up. Look to see a lot of his foals in the arena at this level going forward for sure.
Who rode Electric Code, Pete?
That Jared LeClaire did. Yep. Showed him in his entire deal. Very successful. Okay, he's been making up ground after that first underturn. He's going to want to continue to do it here. Okay, kind of missed that stop at the first part of it. Hit the ground, came out of it, and then went back into it. But got a good stop there. Probably wound up just zero in that maneuver, but it's a good maneuver. He needs to really nail him like this horse is capable of doing is really get in there and hold that stop well. There we go. That's what I was talking about right there. Yes, sir. Much, much better. Look how quiet this horse after all those big rundowns and stops. Just comes around the corner, just waiting on Glenn to ask him to move forward. Good, another stop, not quite as smooth as he'd like it to be, but a good job by Glenn. Nice run overall right there for Team France.
Ranked second in the global rankings for France, Glenn Arthur Estimal completes his routine here on Coded and Karma. Very early in of their team, world number one, Eric Laporte. He posted a 2.16.
Will determine the medals here in the team.
He doesn't look over happy with that, as he
no,
was.
No, you know, you're competitors here. I mean, you're wanting to do well, and like I say, he missed a couple of his stops at that underturn there. So he knew he missed a big chance to really have a big score. You know, there he is. 2:17.5. I mean, that's a good score. And had, you know, an underturn and didn't quite get the stops that he normally can get out of that horse. So I'm sure Glenn's going to be a little disappointed in it, but still a very nice run and good run for the Team France.
And that puts their two competitors on 4:33.5, second behind Italy at the moment. Very early days. 4:39 for Italy with two. That's two competitors' scores. Now for the Netherlands, Jurgen Puls with the 7-year-old Royal Jacques. Famous rider for the Netherlands, who was third to go here in Tryon. Michael Sandick, he posted a 2:17.5.
Very nice turnaround right there. Smooth credit earning plus half. Well, not quite as good there. Lost that cadence, as you can see, and it affects it a lot if they miss that step just a little bit. Puts the timing off and everything. Wound up being like a zero maneuver, but started off first couple of revolutions looking like it was going to be an easy plus maneuver, plus half, but then just lost a cadence in there a couple of different times. So that winds up taking your score right back down for you. Running really fast here and comes back nicely. Yes. Control comes out of that small slow and speeds right back up. Woo! again, the Netherlands is another country that just has a lot of very talented riders there. They are able to compete anywhere in the world. Whenever they go anywhere, everybody's always concerned about them and the team that they bring. They always have really, like I say, very good riders and nice horses. So they're always fighting for those podiums wherever they go, or even in any of the other reining events that we have around the world with NRHA reining or the AQHA reinings, they're always winning them. Right up at the top all the time. Whoop, he slipped out behind over there in lead, and so that's a one-point penalty right there. So that's going to hurt him.
Even a slip will be, will it?
He can slip, but he has to hold that lead. Like, both legs continue on that left side to stay together in lead. If he slips out and he's counter-leading behind for a few strides, then that's a one-point penalty, and that's what happened over there. And if you go as fast as he is and you're running those circles, that's what tends to happen every now and then. You'll step out of lead right there just a little bit. So that's going to hurt. You don't like those one-point penalties. They're hard to make up. Come around here and line down for the rundown. Good solid stop. Nice roll back out of there, real clean. Out of it just a little bit there at the end of the stop. Started off really good, just had a few little bobbles there. Sure gonna knock his score down a little bit, but he'll be happy to come back and try and do it again here.
So Jürgen Pools completes his first routine here at his second World Equestrian Games for the Netherlands, riding Roljak on this occasion. The team Netherlands finished 12th 4 years ago in Normandy in France, looking to improve that score. And that score has now come up on the board for the Netherlands. Jürgen Pools posts a score of 213, 213. Fast rider, 217.5. So 430.5. Pete, you correct me if I'm wrong, but 430.5, I think, for the Netherlands after two competitors.
I think you're doing really good math. Good job.
I'm glad something's going right.
Here's a very talented young lady from Belgium, their second horse in.
And Pulse with Made in Walla, WNL gelding by Walla Walla Wiz. Second team member for Belgium, as you say, Pete. And Belgium with Dries Verschuren posting a 219.5 earlier this morning. He's currently in fifth place.
Yeah, Anne and her husband are a power team in the sport of reining. They just dominate a lot of events in Europe. And like I say, they've been on the silver medal teams the last few games, and they really want to step up and be here. And both of those horses, both of those turns were really nice right there. She had just a little off step at the end of that second turn, but still credit earning turns. And Anne is a superb showman. She wins a lot of events around.
And her husband is Bernard Fonker, I believe. Is that right?
Yes, and he is as well. Like I say, they're sure a power team. I'd have either one of them ride a horse for me and show anywhere in the world.
And Team Belgium.
Oh, yeah.
The team
nice.
That there's a lot of talk about toppling the domination for the US, from the USA.
Really, really big transition right there for Anne. Almost stepped out a little behind, but she, being the showman, kept it in. Didn't get a penalty out of it. Then right back up, she had really, really excellent speed control there. Good lead change and continuing right on.
But it just
here.
That whole S looked so smooth, Pete. Just yeah. coming across the arena. It was just.
And that's the thing you wanted to do is make it look easy. Very nice right there. There she had that nice, nice speed going in that first big circle and then comes right down and just lopes around very soft and very willing. Really credit earning set of circles here on Ann's part. This is a nice gilding, very nice horse. Good lead change right there for Ann. She does what she's always doing, just a solid run. Putting Team Belgium in a good spot right here is what she's doing. Very nice stop and roll back right there. Husband Bernard there was liking it. Coming around the corner here, setting up again for another nice run down. Oh, super. Just super. Could have been a little cleaner on that roll back, but it was okay. Still a credit earning stop. I mean, big stop right there. Ann and Bernard have been training out of Italy for like the last 7-8 years, and I think they're just going to be moving back to Belgium and going to be training back out of their own place there in Belgium. Finish solid. Just like Team Belgium's been doing in the past. Just really solid, good horses, good trainers, good runs.
Well, we've had four competitors from the top. The first 16 get over 20 points. Surely that was our fifth. That was a fabulous performance. Will it look like that from here for the second of the Belgium riders? Belgium, Team Belgium, who've had the team silver medal at the two previous FEI World Equestrian Games. They're looking for the big one, and she goes into the lead. 225.5. 225.5 for Ann Pulse, for Belgium, with Made in Walla, and the delight all over her face. Pete, that was
it should be delight. Beautiful run right there, like I say. Huge degree of difficulty in her circle. She earned a lot of credit right there, more than any other rider had in those circles. That's a tremendous ride right there, and that's what the Team Belgium has been doing and continuing to do. Great run.
Into the lead, go Team Belgium. Early days, but it's 4:45 after two competitors for Team Belgium. Ann Pulse puts the top score on the board so far today here in Tryon at the first of the 3 days of FEI reigning. Ann Pulse, 225.5.
What a great run. Like I say, she's just a fabulous competitor. And has just continues to crank out big score after big score. She's just a great showman. What a nice little gilding too.
We're now on to team competitor number two for Brazil, Joao Felipe Lacerda, with Gonna Done It Again. Another 7-year-old by Colonel Smoking Gun. This one a stallion. Well, Pete, the Belgians came into this with some, there was a lot of talk about them as a team to try to get that medal off you guys. And that's a good start for them, those two.
They are. That's a great start for both of their competitors. And they've got two more strong riders and horses coming up. And like I said before, I sure look for them to be right up there at the very top without any doubt. So, and this team here, Brazil, is loaded as well. And we're seeing their second team rider come in right here.
Yeah, they had a 221, didn't they? They had a 216 from Marcelo Almeida da Silva, Brazil.
Yes, on his on the first run for the
run,
team.
Yeah.
Yep. And a 21 on their individual. But they
yeah, that's right.
They'll
yeah.
be fine. Two really good turnarounds right there. Very attractive horse here. Comes down to a very good small slow. Stepping back up now. Good lead change. Continuing to hustle this horse right through these circles. Very nice set of circles there. Just another one stepping right up, just coming in one run after the next. This is some fun watching right here, Phil. I think Team Brazil was liking it as well.
We're watching Philippe Lacerda for Brazil, second of their four team members.
Just right. Good change. Yep, now comes the fun part for him, running down and doing these big stops. They need him to finish out real strong here. They had a little bit of a lower score for the team to start on that first run, so they need him to really push through, and he did. Big stop right there, nice row back. Very exciting. Good stop. He's going to have a solid score here, Phil. He's going to help his team tremendously.
Now for the last rundown.
Again, look how that horse just willingly ran down there, had his ears up, was very happy. He's extremely happy. They're extremely happy. It's all good here in Tryon, North Carolina, USA.
We're here in the arena, the Johnson Controls reigning arena at the FEI World Equestrian Games, a purpose-built arena just for this competition. And that is a score posted by team member number two for Brazil, 221.5, 221.5 for Jair Philippe Lacerda, and Gunner done it again, 75 from judge one. Of course, there's five judges. They discard the top and the bottom score, and the middle three, the median scores, count. Very good system. 221.5.
What a great run. He had a fabulous run. And again, it just continues to show the versatility and the quality of our riders and horses all over the world.
Well, just as we're going into the next drag, when they prepare the arena for the next six horses, Brazil with two riders gone, 437.5, and this is the team competition, so we'll just focus on that for the moment. At the moment, Belgium 445 are out in front with two riders. Of course, we've got another two riders to come from each of these teams, and they'll be later on this afternoon. We've got all the individuals as well. We'll talk more about that as we let the tractors come in to the arenas to smooth it out for the next part of this session one here in Tryon, North Carolina. For the moment, Pete and I will just cut the microphones and just sit here for a few minutes waiting for the tractors to do their bit. We'll be right back.
This year, and also check out more online at Briar Horses. drivehorses.com here in the World Equestrian Games. And it's drag time.
Ricardo está aquí al frente, aquí, aquí, ahí. Está la llave, ya no quiere ir. ¿Quieren? ¿Cortamos esto? Voy a llevar un poncho solo por...
¿Va a seguir el rally?
¿Sí? Va a dejar eso ahí.
Welcome back to the side of the arena here at Tryon. We're here at the 2018 World Equestrian Games. We're on day one and we're at the reining. And at the moment, we have seen some tremendous performances. We've had 18 of the 63 competitors. Today is the team competition and the qualifier for the individual. 12 nations are here with teams, 21 nations in all taking part. And at the moment, we've had two competitors from Belgium. Welcome back to the side of the arena here at the FEI World Equestrian Games in Tryon, day one of the FEI reigning. And we're here with competitor number 19, Jose Vasquez Hernandez for Mexico with Gunolina Colonel. Another great reigning horse by Colonel Smoke and Gun.
Jose is the father of the young lady that competed earlier here. Like I say, they're from up in the Chicago area now, from Mexico. They have a good group of horses that they go and show all over the world. Jose's a great guy, great competitor, wins a lot of major non-pro events all over. He's capable of competing on any level that he wants to here and will do a great job here from Mexico. Really pretty little horse right here. Nice little gelding.
And his daughter, Mariana Vasquez Rodriguez, put a 206 on the board earlier.
Jose's doing a great job. Very nice set of circles both ways here. Comes back nicely. Cute, look at that little horse, ears up. Just great expression to him. Steps back up. Gets through his change very nice. Completes that circle. Very credit earning set of circles there. Both the sets were, you know, easily got plus half on both of them. Creasing down for the stop. Oh yeah, very nice stop. A little bit draggy coming out of that roll back, you know, where his horse counter arc there, just a little bit against that outside ring, but not bad, you know, not bad at all. Didn't hold that ground as good as he normally does. This horse came out with those hind feet out of that stop, just kind of stubbed a toe, it looked like, is what happened into that ground. Sometimes when they go in, they've got to get that feet flat so that they can hit on top of that ground. And he actually got his hind foot hit with the toe going down, so it kind of pulled it out on him a little bit. Just an unfortunate deal. It didn't hurt him at all, but comes back and really stops like he knows how to stop. Great stop right there.
Just whilst we're watching Jose just complete his routine, Pete, you know, this Gunnelina Colonel, Viscount Smoking Gun, I want to just talk about the stallions, because clearly Colonel Smoking Gun is a prolifically successful stallion in the sport. Do you get, are there many great stallions like that?
Yeah, you know, we've been fortunate with our reining industry to have a lot of great stallions, you know, like Topsail Wiz and Shining Spark and a whole numerous amount of great stallions, you know. And Colonel Smoking Gun is just another one along the line. And again, we have more younger ones coming along that'll be producing, continue to produce great reiners for us as we go. The sport of reining's got so specialized as well that we're there only breeding these horses to do reining and to do it well. And so that's what these horses are really coming into.
Well, now we go back to Australia, Martin Larkum with Colonel Smart Spook, 12-year-old stallion by Smart Spook.
Here's an amazing rider from Australia. He's won many world champions. He's an extremely nice gentleman. There's not a more competitive person than Martin, no. I tell you, he works really hard and is very talented and does a fabulous job with his horses. Nice turnaround, probably a zero, just didn't quite, he was sucked back a little bit on his hind feet and just didn't quite get turned around quite as quick as he normally can. This is more like what I'm used to seeing this horse turn. That was excellent right there, very good turnaround. This is really a nice horse, and he had a great show career earlier. Been out to stand in at stud and breeding mares, and Martin got him back up, and owners were gracious enough to let him bring him out here and show him, and I expect some an awful good run here out of him.
Australia just missed out on a medal at the last World Equestrian Games in Normandy, where they finished fifth, two off the podium. Again, you could see a better performance from them this week.
Oh yes, they've got a very talented group of riders, you know, and Martin later on here has his sister is a competitor and very successful as well, and just like that, they're always right at the top of the ranks at all times too. To be fifth out there in Normandy was a huge accomplishment, and I know that they were a little disappointed that they didn't get up there a little higher. And they're sure working hard here. As you can see, this horse is really running. Martin's doing a great job of asking him, and this talented horse, so he'll have a big run here. There we go. Comes back to another nice, small, slow. Good transition right there. Right back out to that big circle, and Martin is not wasting any time putting his foot on the gas pedal and making him step right up and go. And this fine stallion is responding well. goodly change. Lined him up here. Got a lot of fresh dirt down there in front of him. Oh, yes. Very nice stop. Got out of the row back well. Good job by Martin. Good stop. Got out of that row back.
218 from their first competitor, Robin Schiller, earlier this morning.
Yeah, they're off to a good start as a team here, and I expect Martin to have a very good score here as well. Wants to finish this really big. And does. Nice stop. Great job by Martin. There's his daughter and wife. They're all excited about it, I tell you.
And it's his sister that's competed for Australia at the last two World Equestrian Games, I think she did. Is that
yes,
right?
Yes, that's correct. Yes.
So, waiting for the score for Australia as Martin Larcombe, second member of the Australian team, with Colonel Smart Spook, completes his routine. 216.5. 216.5. For Martin Larcombe.
Yeah. He'll be a little disappointed in that. That first turnaround had to hurt him a little bit, and that one stop just keep staying in there a little bit, but still a good run for him.
434.5 for Australia after two riders. Current leaders, Belgium. 445 for Belgium. That's the where we are at the moment. Early days with still two members of these teams to come. So Australia, 434.4. It's all 34. 434.5. Robin Schiller and Martin Larcombe. Now we go to Germany, and Germany have had a great start to this competition. First team member Grisha Ludwig posted 223.5, which is the second best score that we've seen today, equal with Casey Deary for the United States. So, Marcus Schütting and Spotlight Charlie for Germany, looking to capitalize on that great start that Grisha Ludwig's given Germany.
Very nice turn, a little bit under there, so he's going to get that penalty half plus half on the turnaround, though. Even though you have a penalty, it doesn't necessarily affect the score, the maneuver score. You can have a real quality turn like those plus half, so they're going to give you that maneuver score of a plus half and then hit him on the penalty there. Very nice turnaround, finished it real strong. Stopped dead on right where he needed to be. There's another plus half for him. Good start, Marcus. Boy, he is not afraid to step out here and go. Look at this horse running around just really good. Then comes back very nice. Very nice. I'm telling you, Team Germany showed up here. They're ready to come and win some medals now. Right back out there, not afraid to go try and win something. This is a high difficulty, and so it makes it to where this horse can maybe make a mistake quicker just because of the speed. No different than you being in your car and driving really fast and then coming around a curve. You better be talented to handle that car at that kind of speed. And that's just what Marcus is doing here. He has stepped that level up. And then we see him bring him right back, and this horse comes back very nice. Very nice. And look at him just quietly just getting around right here in that circle. High credit earning set of circles right here for Marcus. Now, is that lead change? Now all he needs to do is just finish out three good little stops here and he will be right up there with his partner, Grisha. They'll be happy together. Good job, he made a really nice long run down there. Got into a stop, got back out of his rollback okay. Little bit in and out of that stop, not bad though. I mean, that was good. Love that approach. This approach is like right here where they turn around the corner and start building to that. This horse is a really nice approach and runs down there really long and free. Really nice stop and roll back right there. He's wanting to finish with one more.
But my reckoning, Pete, if he can get a 2-2-2 or above, Germany go ahead of Belgium. That's just by my back of a piece of paper reckoning here.
Well, if he can finish out here, he's going to be close to that range right there for sure. Okay, nice stop. He'll be pushing them. He's going to push right up there on them. Right,
Germany looking
here
for a 2-2-2. To get them into the lead going into the break. We've still got 6-10 horses still to come before the break. The culmination of the team medals will be this afternoon. Let's just have a look.
He's going to have a nice score here. It's going to put them right up there where they want them.
Well, he's got exactly that.
Look at you call that, Phil. I'm talking. I'm going to have to go find another job.
2-2-2 is exactly what he got. So Germany go into the lead, half a point ahead of Belgium. That was a great run by Marcus Schütting, Spotlight Charlie.
Yeah, I'm telling you, all of these countries, they have come hooked up. Their riders are ready. Their horses are ready. They're all competing and doing a great, great job here. How about that? That's some excitement right there. Have all of these countries doing so well.
Now for Canada. Austin Seelhoff with the 10-year-old Lipstick Jungle. A mare by Big Checks to Cash.
Austin's a great young trainer from out Western Canada. He has been on fire out there, just dominating all of their reignings. This year he's had a great year. He's a great young man and going to have a bright future in this sport for a long time. Nice set of turnarounds right there, just probably a solid zero, real clean, just needed just a little more briskness to the step, but really solid and clean there. Good, finished up nice as well.
Canada.
Two solid turnarounds right there for him.
One of the three teams, Pete, with just three competitors. So all the scores have to count, no discount score.
Canada has truly a lot of great horsemen. They always are competitive with their teams. They've got several other very talented riders coming up as well. Just very smooth, very clean. Comes back really nice. This horse was raised by Joe Hayes, who is a great breeder, trainer, and judge that was unfortunately in a tragic accident earlier this summer. And he was actually supposed to be the head judge here at the WEG Games. And so I want to give a little call out to his wife Liz and son about him, and he's a great person. Nobody was any better in the world than Joe Hayes. I mean, just an outstanding person. There's never a bad word come out of his mouth. He was always smiling, and he was a great breeder, has raced a lot of great horses just like this one, and then also a fabulous judge. And it's a huge loss for our industry and part of our reigning family to have lost Joe so early. So we hate that, but I'm really glad to see Austin doing a really good job with this mare, showing her, and I know Joe would be proud of her. Really nice run down right there. Oh,
that was quick.
Very good stop. Yeah, very nice job. Yeah. Nice long run down. Like I say, you can see Austin. He's got future wrote all over him. I mean, he's a talented young man and doing a great job now. And he's got a lot of bright times in front of him for sure. Here he comes down trying to get ready for that second stop. She hesitated just a little on him. Being a smart rider he is, he went ahead and took her on down the arena a little farther and made her get on down there and get to a good stop. If he'd have taken it right there, she would have shorted him, and changing out to that right lead would have stopped sideways, wouldn't have been a good stop. I mean, that's where these guys are showmen and really get the best out of their horse. Good job right there, Austin.
Look at the smile.
That's a great finish. Beautiful. Right there. Beautiful, wasn't it? Yes, beautiful run down, increased really smooth, went long. Mare just went all the way to the stop for him. Really good job.
Well, what a great finish for the 29-year-old Canadian Austin Seelhoff. And Lipstick Jungle, the first of the three members of the Canadian team. So this will be their first score posted for Canada. 2:15. We've just heard the announcer. 2:15. That's the first score for Team Canada. Austin Seelhoff for Lipstick Jungle. 2:15. That puts him as an individual in 17th equal place. Remind ourselves that it's the top 15 from today's competition go forward to the individual final on Saturday, and then tomorrow the next 20 in the lineup here go into a consolation competition tomorrow, and the top five of that consolation competition also join the top 15 on Saturday in the individual.
And he'll surely make it in that next group to be able to compete tomorrow to try and be in that top five for sure.
Now we go to Austria. 22-year-old Anna Lisick with This Wimp's So Fly. 8-year-old gelding by Wimpy's Little Step. Just looking at my notes here, Pete. Wimpy's Little Step, the sire of this horse in the Hall of Fame. Yep. The National Reining Horse Association.
Yeah, Wimpy's Little Step is another one of our leading sires, and he is Palomino. So there you go.
I'll mention that to my daughter.
But he's been a great sire for us, and all his foals are really good foals, very good competitor. He was a great individual, won the reining fraternity, and has been just a marvelous sire for us. This young lady is an extremely talented young lady, has been competing in Europe and just doing very well. As you say, 22 years old, she's young, but that age doesn't mean anything to her. She's not afraid to go compete in any reining anywhere with anyone, and you can see why right here. Good job right there.
Multi-medalists in the young rider sections of this sport.
Yes, sir. And she's on a good team here. You know, we've got a couple other good riders coming up behind her, Martin and Rudy, and so they've got a great team right here. They really do.
Right, Canada, just three members of their team. Anna being the first of those three. A lot of pressure on the young lady to get them off on a good start this morning here in Triumph.
Good job. Hustled that horse right around there. Came back to that small, slow, nice. Part of her teammates hollering there for her. This young lady's quite experienced. Like you say, she showed in a lot of the junior FEI events and has come through the ranks. This is the great thing about our sport is being able to have all of our junior events that brings up the kinds like the Marianne from Mexico and Anna here, and then Cade McCutcheon, and the whole future of reining looks really bright, you know, young people like them.
And interesting, those three names that you just mentioned, you've got a North American, South American, and European. Which,
yes,
incredible.
That is good. Like say, it's all over our globe. I tell you, it's a great sport. And she's really doing a nice job here. I mean, man, she's laying down a nice batter. This horse has just been right under control with her the whole way. Just been very responsive. Very nice set of circles both ways. Get down there and finish these big stops out and have, she will be a happy little girl when she gets done today. Oh yes, very good. She built up to that stop really well. Nice rowback, just waited there a second, let her horse get his balance and then brought him out. A more unexperienced rider would have maybe rushed that roll back a little bit and would have got in trouble and not had as good a roll back. She did a great job of waiting on her horse, letting him get his balance back to him from that stop to where he could get out of there. Good job, Anna.
Pete, I'm seriously impressed with this because this is the first time this lady's ridden at this level. She's early in her early 20s. She's the first member carrying her nation's flag here at the World Equestrian Games, and she is putting in some performance.
She is really doing a great job. I mean, just so cool as a cucumber right there, this young lady is. Just marvelous. And what a nice horse. Great little gilding.
Now the last rundown. The first competitor for Austria, Anna Lisek.
And finish strong. Very good, back up. Oh, very good, back up, aggressive there.
What a tremendous start for Austria. Every score has to count because they have just the three competitors, but Anna Lisek, 22 years old, gets Austria on the way. Let's just wait for her score.
She'll be happy with this score. It's a really nice run. It's going to be a very solid score and put the team right up there to where they need to be.
220.5. She's topped 220. 220.5. That is a great place for the Team Austria to get on their way. Their other two main members will come in the second session later on this afternoon. So 220.5 for Anna Lisek. This wimps so fly for Austria. Now we move to the sole competitor representing Finland. Maria Astikainen riding Antares Martin. And the 12-year-old gelding, this one by Taris Martin. And the only competitor in Finland, so individual looking for a placing in that individual final on Saturday. 63 competitors representing 21 nations have come forward for day one here in Tryon for the FEI reigning. 12 teams plus the individuals.
Good start for her, very nice turnaround. Kind of got a little counter arc there at the very end of it, but very nice step and start. Yeah, talking about all the other disciplines, we have endurance running going out across the countryside of North Carolina right now. They're going to be out there all day competing, and they had their start early this morning, and And luckily, it's a beautiful day outside here at Tryon, and so they should have a great competition.
And I believe the dressage is taking place in the main arena as well. It's full of action here at Tryon at the 2018 World Equestrian Games. The venue here, absolutely awesome. This building that you're seeing, purpose-built for this reining competition and for the vaulting, which we'll get bring to you later on this week. And the riders are saying, Pete, that the surface is absolutely tremendous.
And Tryon has done an excellent job. They brought in Jim Kaiser to prepare all the ground here for the reiners, and they've done their normal outstanding job of preparing the ground, and it is fabulous for us. And the arena, the warm-up arenas and everything here are working out just really, really good. And that's the other thing too that we really enjoy as reiners is we get to intermingle here at the World Equestrian Games with all the other different disciplines. We had earlier in the week, it was really hot here, and the eventers, we had our USA team come down and talk to our USA reining team about how to help cool their horses out and do some of that. And so it's really great fun to be able to have the different disciplines of great horsemen. No matter what you're doing, you're still just a horseman, and you're concentrating on that animal and doing the best that you can for that horse. And we all work together and trade off ideas and suggestions and training techniques that they do, that we do, and what works for us and them. And so and then business too. The other night, a bunch of us were all talking about our different business scenarios and how to make things more successful for each of us in business along. And it's all the same. We're just doing different events, but it's all truly the same thing, that everybody truly is here for the love of this great horse that we're all competing on and enjoying.
Well said, Pete.
Maria is getting along good here. She had just a little bit of a bobble there on that stop, but not bad. She's had a nice, solid, smooth run, and we're really glad to have her here competing from Finland. And hopefully get a few more of her comrades back home to step up and compete with her here as well. Okay, whoops, a little jump there over the hat. She's okay though. Oh, he shorted her just a little bit on that stop, and so didn't get quite far enough down the arena the way she wanted, but we're like, say, great job by her being here, representing her country, did a fabulous job, great young lady.
So representing Finland, flying the flag for Spring Ranch in Finland, Maria Astikainen and Antaris Martin completes her routine. Trained by the great Sean Florida, followed into the sport, followed her parents into the sports, I should say.
Nice solid run right there to mark a 2:10, a good average score. She had some good, really good things in there for her, and so very positive in some areas for Marie.
2:10, exactly 2:10. For Maria Astikainen, and Antaris Martin for Finland, bidding to get into that top 15 for the big individual final on Saturday. And let's have a look at the standings. Still that great performance from Belgium, from Anna Pouls on Maiden Waller, 225.5. This is the team competition, and the current leaders, half a point ahead of Belgium, are Germany on 4:45. We now go into another drag time before we get the final six in day one of the FEI reining competition here at the 2018 World Equestrian Games Tryon. We'll be a break for 5 or 6 minutes. Come back with us. The next competitor to go for United States, 18-year-old Cade McCutcheon. We'll be right back.
Plush toys and greeting cards at the Brooklyn USA shop on sale to support the Brooks work, charity efforts for service animals all around the world. So with that, we're going to take our final drag break of the day. Jim Kaiser, our putting expert, making his way into the bag to drag before we move on to our 25th position in the
welcome back to the final session here this morning at the FEI World Equestrian Games. This is the fifth and final session prior to the break before this afternoon of day one of the FEI reigning. Belgium has posted the best score on the board, Anna Bulls with Maiden Waller put a 225.5 on the board, but that wasn't enough to keep the Belgium team, and this is all about the team medals in front, because after the two competitors from each team, Germany are currently in front with a total score of the two riders of 445.5, half a point ahead of Germany. Well, we have had some excellent sport. I'm Phil Gazzara. I'm joined with Pete Kyle alongside me. Pete, we've seen, what have we had so far? We've had 24 competitors. We've seen some amazing performances, and it's very close to the top.
It really is, and I tell you what, we haven't seen the best yet. I'm going to guarantee you that. Ann's run will compete with anybody's run all week long here, but today we're going to see some more really, really good riders come in here and great horses, and this is one young man right here coming in that's quite capable for even his quite young age to be able to compete here.
Cade McCutcheon, one of only two riders competing here in the FEI reigning of the World Equestrian Games who are actually born this century. So Cade McCutcheon, 18 years old, second rider for the reigning champions, United States of America. Casey Deary posted a 223.5 earlier on in the competition, and now it's down to Cade McCutcheon, son of Tom McCutcheon, multi-gold medal winner from previous FEI World Equestrian Games, sadly not taking part this weekend due to his horse going lame, which I know has been a heartbreak for him, Pete.
Oh, it truly was. Tom's a huge competitor, and how about that?
Look
right there.
That,
start that young boy right off there with a huge turnaround. This was sad for Tom, but Tom's taking care of his horse. His horse was off just a little bit here after preparing him and getting him ready, and he made that really tough decision to take care of his horse and not push him into the games here. He could have easily made it in, I think, but Tom did the right thing for his horse, and that's what he's all about. He's a great horseman, and how about both of those turnarounds for Cade right there? This is a great horse owned by his grandmother and grandfather, Tim and Colleen McQuay. We've been talking about pedigree on these horses and how they're great and how it goes. And this is as good a pedigree for a person as you can get. His dad's a gold medal, a multi-world champion. His grandfather's a gold medal winner as well, a multi-world champion. His mother's a gold medal winner in France and multi-time world champion herself and number one leading non-pro rider in the world. And so he has every right.
And custom made gun is by Colonel Smoking Gun. So
yeah, it's all the breeding in the world is right here in front of us. And Cade is taking advantage of it. He's cool as a cucumber, this young man, for 18 years old. I'm just amazed with him at all times. He's grown up with it. He's been ate up with it. And he is a fabulous showman. And look right here, there's not a stage too big for him. He doesn't care how big the stage is.
And there's a lot of pressure on this young man's shoulders because the United States are the reigning champions and the Europeans, the Mexicans, South Americans, they're all snapping at their heels. So a lot of pressure on the rider number two, the teenager from the United States.
Exactly, and he's had a fabulous run. This is a great horse. Cade has really rode this horse a lot and shown him and had a great career with him. His grandfather, Tim, has shown him and done very, very well with him. And he's putting out a good run right here. Got that lead change. Now he's just got to come to those three big stops and cannot be more excited for this young man.
Cade McCutcheon, rider number two for Team USA. First rundown.
Building up for that stop. Oh my goodness, look how deep in the ground that horse got. Did you see where he just bent and those hocks got right down on the ground? I'm telling you. I watched this horse school the other day, Phil, and he actually stopped so strong on his hocks which are up there, he actually burned the bottom of his hock stopping just a little bit. So this horse is such a phenomenal athlete. Oh my goodness. Attaboy, Kate, he knocks out another one. What a nice, nice run he's got going here. Huge stops, great horse. Needs one more stop for Team USA to have another really strong score. And how about this young man, Phil, here at 18 years
it's
old?
It's unbelievable.
Super. Nice stop. Smart showman right there backing up. He knows it.
Pete, if we hadn't seen somebody right up there, he may well have put Team USA into the lead, going into the break in a few moments' time. Casey Deary, 223.5. If he can do a 223, 224, we have got clear leader with the United States. He's gone 229.
I was going to say, I'm going to guarantee it's going to be more than that 23.
229, and look at the look on young Cade McCutcheon's face. He's 18 years old. He's at his first ever FEI World Equestrian Games, and he's heading the field here in triumph. Well, what a superb performance from this young man, following, as Pete described, in footsteps of relations to the legends of the sport. The new kid on the block, 229. I think he almost looks a bit bewildered by that.
What a great run. All his teammates are down there just tugging on him. There's his dad, Tom. What a great job by that young man. What a great, great horse that is.
452.5 by my reckoning, Team USA after their two riders. And as you can see by the reaction, Pete, as you say, by the reaction of everybody out there, this is a huge moment for this young man.
Oh, huge for anybody, but for an 18-year-old to be able to be here on this stage and have that kind of run is just phenomenal. Just phenomenal. What a great, great run.
Marcello Troncoso Ibanez for Chile with Aladino. So Chile, three riders. This is the first of the three, so they've got a team, but all three count.
It's great to see Chile up here competing. Their country down there that are also very good horsemen in South America, and they have been working hard at getting better prepared and coming up here to compete and doing an excellent job. Watched them school here this week, and they've made big gains in their horsemanship and their horses both. Oh, had a little penalty there, had that overturn. Solid, smooth turnaround, and going to have that penalty there. So again, that's the thing you want to stay out of, is that old penalty box. I mean, that thing hurts you quickly. There you go. Very nice turnaround that direction for him. Good job.
And although maybe not in this sport yet, but Chileans, of course, great horsemen in their own right.
Yes, they are. Their country is they've had a lot of great horsemen come out of there. And like I say, they're starting off right now like what Europe was about 15 years ago in the sport of reining, and these guys are going to catch up quick. And just like all the other competitors around the world, you can see that everybody's on an equal basis and doing a great job. And these young men right here from Chile are on that road to success, and I think going to be very successful in the long run.
Seven-year-old.
Yep, they brought their horses up. You know, they raised right there in Chile, which is always a fun accomplishment to be able to raise one, bring it, show it on this level, this stage here. for the whole world to see the kind of animal that you're producing out of your home country. It's a real honor. He's doing a really nice job. Real smooth, real clean, staying out of trouble. Had that one underturn there in the, or overturn in the first turn, but getting along well. You're going to be fortunate enough in this afternoon session to have Tom McCutcheon come up and work with you. So I think you'll enjoy his commentary a lot more than mine. He's a lot of fun to be with, and he'll be able to give a good different angle for everybody here that's watching.
Well, Pete, believe me, Tom's son's just done a superb performance, but Tom's got some big shoes to fill to sit in your place right here.
Oh, well, thank you for that. I don't know about that, but you'll enjoy him. He's very articulate, and he's very good, so he'll bring a lot to it. Good job right here, getting through his pattern real clean. Came out of that stop a little bit. That's going to hurt his score. His overall score is going to be down just a little, but as far as everything, very good run. No major problems. Everything very clean. Really good job. There we go. Got in there. And there he comes in for a big, strong finish. That a boy. Way to go. Nice job right there. So glad to see him up here competing. Very good.
And that is a great finish for Chile, Marcelo Troncoso Ibanez and the 7-year-old Aladino. First rider of the trio for Chile.
The scoring for our ladder from Chile, the first of their three on the team, it will be a 208 and one.
That's a good score right there for him. A 208 and a half, had several 70s, you know, had a couple of little maneuvers there, but a good solid run, a very good start for that team, and they're just have anywhere to go but straight up, I'm telling you.
208.5 for the first of the three riders for Chile, Marcelo Troncoso Ibanez and Aladino. And now we move to Italy, the third team member. Just two of the nations will have three team members go before the break, before we break for the afternoon. We go into the afternoon session later on, local time. At 1600 hours here in North Carolina. Italy, third team member. Gennaro Lendi with Spats Topsail Bar.
Gino here has been very successful. He's won many multiple gold medals in competitions in Europe for Team Italy, along with many individual awards. I mean, this guy is extremely talented, and look right here, right off the bat, huh? Start that turnaround, huge turnaround right there. Oh, really good. Had a little stumble, just the horse just took a bad little stumble, didn't hurt him at all. That's a big turnaround both directions.
Look how
really good.
Calm, that horse is just looking around, and
yes, great minded.
Yeah,
great minded quarter horse. This Italian team, they're a veteran team, they're extremely seasoned, and Gino here is part of that. Like I say, they've won a lot of medals, they know where they're at, they've won silver and gold medals in all these different competitions, and they're coming in hungry as well, wanting to get on that platform. And so Gino here, he's going to try and set them right into that. Both of his previous team had really good runs. Oop, little bobble there. Luckily, no major penalty, just a maneuver deduction, but he can make up for it here. Change there. Gino's doing a good job just maneuvering through his circles, real correct. Trying to earn those extra little pluses here, just little plus there, little plus there. Get the strength of your horse and then make sure you just keep out of trouble. Got his change completed. And he'll be moving down for his rundowns. Good. Nice stop. Roll back. Got out of there clean.
Rider number three for the Italian quartet.
Yeah, with them drawing up early, they wound up having three in this session. Still have one more to go later tonight.
221, 218 on the board so far.
Yeah, first two. Oh, there you go. Very nice stop right there for Gino. Really good. Wants to finish out with one more just like that to try and get bump that score as high as he can for his team. Wow. Just had timing wrong, had a stumble right there. Just unfortunate. That happens in all sports where your timing gets off just a little bit as you're going and they hit it. And so makes for an unfortunate stop there that's going to be a little minus maneuver. It's going to hurt him more in his score, and so he's going to be real disappointed there. Needed that last score to stop really good to try and bump that score up, and it went the other direction on him. So still a nice horse, and Gino's a super veteran showman, and he'll come back for that individual and be barreling again.
But his first two rundowns, Pete, they looked absolutely fine.
Yeah, they were good. Like I say, he's still going to have a nice score. Like, there it is, 219. And so that'll put him up there to where he can come back for that individual or that next offer, and he'll definitely get in there again. I mean, he's talented, and that horse just had an unfortunate stumble there.
Well, Gino Lendi and Spat Top Sale Bar, 219 on the board, and by my reckoning, that puts Italy with their three riders gone, and they have a fourth later, the best three scores count, but I reckon they're on 6-5-8 at the moment. There will only be two nations, Pete, as you mentioned, that will actually have two of the nations have three riders before we go in to the break. That'll be Italy, we've just seen, in France. Now for the United States, as an individual, Gabe Hutchins, FM Shiner Tag Chess, 7-year-old by Wizen Tag Chess.
Gabe, he's a trainer up in the Northwest up there for Tamarack Ranch, and he's a very talented young man. And when Tom's horse had to pull out, he was our guy to step right in. He flew right in here and excited to be on the team. And he's just a super, we're super proud to have him representing Team USA and himself and going for the individual here. And this is really a nice horse. Had a really good turnaround there in the first turnaround, and a nice turnaround in the second one. Gabe's going to try and continue to get a nice high score and make it real easy to get in that top 15 here for Team USA to try and go for those medals in the individual.
Individuals.
Which it's really a nice format that FEI did to change the format to where used to the individuals didn't get to compete. The alternates, they didn't get to compete for an individual. They were only here in case something bad happened to one of their teammates. So it was really good that they're now letting them show and have that chance to go and compete on Saturday for their individual medals. So, and Gabe's wasting no time here. He's making good ends of his opportunity, I'm telling you. Again, nice horse, good circles both directions. Come back nice, big pretty mover. Gabe's very talented trainer and showman. Good job. Gets down there and wants to get that good stops done, all three of them, so he can bring home a good score here. Turned that corner, started running pretty strong, but he got him down there. Oh, came out of the end of that stop right there. You can see, and then had a little bit of a trot right there, so that's going to hurt his scores right there. He got in that ground really good, Phil, but that's what you want him to do, is stay in there. And if you lose that at the end of your stop and come up and out of it, then that hurts your score. That's a minus score. So there he
goes. That was a lot better, wasn't it?
That's what he's wanting. See how that horse pushed at the end? So that's what he was wanting out of him on that first stop. So he'll be disappointed on that first stop, but that's making ground right there. There he goes. Two of them there at the end. Very good. Unfortunate for that stop.
Great finish, though.
Great finish. Yeah, very nice. Both of those came back really, really good.
Riding as an individual for the United States of America, Gabe Hutchins, FM Shine and Tag Checks, completes his routine.
Again, well, they're all competitors here. I mean, they've shown they know when they make a mistake. They know their run when it's a great one, like Kate did, and when you've had not your best run. And this horse, it was really good, but for sure wasn't his best run. So he'll get a chance to come back, though, and be able to go in that next group and make that individual again. And I expect him to have much, much better run.
216.5 for Gabe Hutchins, FM Shine and Tag Checks for the United States. Puts him in equal 16th place at the moment. We've just got two to go before we complete the first session. In fact, the first half day here at the 2018 World Equestrian Games here at the Tryon International Equestrian Center here in North Carolina, America. It's a great day for reining. It's a very, very competitive competition. Two riders to go before we end the first session for France. Rider number three for the French team, Mathieu Bouton and Gunnar Sassia. 8-year-old gelding. Another one by the great Colonel Smoking Gun.
There you go. Very nice turnaround from Matthew. Another great young man training right there in Texas now. His own business he's running there and doing a fabulous job. Good. Two solid turns right there by Matthew. This young man, he does a great job with his horses and is a good showman. We're just fortunate in the reining industry to have so many outstanding people, and he's just another one of them that are fun to be around and really put a lot of dedication and hard work into these animals and take great care of them. And Matthew is a talented young man as well. He had a huge run. I watched in May him show this horse and had a huge run in the second go-around of a FEI event out here in May. And I look for him to have a good score here. What a pretty horse, Phil. I mean, this thing is well balanced, has a really good look about him, you know, uses himself well here. Very athletic.
.216, .217.5 are the two scores on the French scoreboard at the moment for the first two team members.
Matthew's doing a really nice job of showing his horse here. A little bit bigger, small circle there, but very controlled. That's where he guided him. It's not out of place at all. Very nice. Credit earning set of circles right here. Really hustling this horse around there. He'll easily plus half that maneuver, that set of circles right there.
As a team, just looking at the scores that we've seen, you know, they need a good 220 plus to keep in contention.
Yeah, they really do. They need to really get a big big score here. And I tell you what, Matthew's trying to help his team all he can. Boy, that was beautiful right there. Great, great stop. Good roll back. See how that horse just softly came out real straight and right back over his hocks. I mean, very nicely job. Very nicely done by Matthew. Come on, Matthew. Get down there, partner. Yeah, that a boy. I'm telling you, he's doing a good job here. What a nice little horse. One more stop here and he'll have a good score for his team. Yes. Look how deep that horse pushed right there. Look how soft he is there in the bridle. Good job. Great run there, Matthew.
And that completes. Completes Team France's third member, Matthew Buteau, world number five, completes his routine, looking for a score in the 220s to try to keep his team in contention here on day one of the FBI reigning. It's the team medals today.
He likes that right
and
there.
And he's got it. It's 222.5. 222.5.
Ah, good job right there. And how about him? He gave all the credit to his horse. He knows his horse is a great horse, and he did a fabulous job. He had 74s across the boards on those judges. A very consistent deal. We've got a great group of judges from all over the world that are judging it. And so it's really nice to have that many different judges, and they're all here just doing the sport what they need to be doing and judging the horses the way they see it.
Last in the morning session from Uruguay, Gabriel Diano with the 8-year-old Magnum Starlights. Stallion by Magnum Chick Green. Sorry, Magnum Chick Dream.
Yep. Really great young sire there, Josh and Carrie Vishers. He's a fabulous horse, had a great record himself, and has sired some really good young horses that are competing well.
Uruguay with two individual riders competing here in Triumph. France's score with one rider to come. They can discard one just to bring you up to date as they've had three riders go. 6.56 by my reckoning, by my working out.
Good job. Gabriel trains, has a training business right south of Oklahoma City. And has been up here in the States, I think, for 6 or 7 years, and does a great job. Oh, shoot. His horse just stepped on his other foot there, and that stopped it. That's a bad break. I mean, he's very very good. You know, you can see he's got protective gear on his feet there and on his legs. They do that just to protect those horses in case of an accident like that happening. And so the horse is good, but it was an unfortunate maneuver deduction for him right there. So this guy is extremely good showman and has had a lot of success here. in the state showing, like I say, has a very good business and talented horse right here. So, you know, that unfortunately he can hopefully make it up. Look how he just comes back and so pretty. I mean, just a pretty, pretty horse loping around. There he goes. Gabriel stepping it right back up, trying to gain a few of those points that he lost on that turnaround, trying to ease himself into the individual finals with just that, without having to come back on that next run. This horse is just doing his business, I'm telling you. He's just marching right through there, doing whatever Gabriel asks. Very good, came back to a small slow really well, very controlled. Again, excellent balance. Okay, this horse is also a big stopper, Phil. I look for Gabriel to go down there and nail all three of these stops. Very nice, very smooth, good roll back. Came out of it very good. All of those young men from South America, as you can see, Brazil, Uruguay, Paraguay, Chile, all of them. I mean, they're just a good group of horsemen as well, and a lot of fun to be around. And how about that? Well, that's getting right down in that dirt right there. Now he's playing in the dirt for sure. One more stop out of Gabriel here. Good, just ran him down real smooth. Got a nice little stop, didn't want to overdo his horse. Great young man, a lot of good supporters there for him, I'm guaranteeing it.
And that completes it for Uruguay. The first of two competitors representing Uruguay, Gabriel Diano, Magnum Starlights, pleases the crowd here in Triumph as we come to the end of our first session of the first day of all the competition here at the FEI World Equestrian Games, certainly the first day of reigning. And we will be going live for the last 33 competitors at 1600, so we'll be on air at 15:55. Let's have a look at the standings. The 18-year-old Cade McCutcheon, 2:29, has put the Team US in front. Early days, great start also for Belgium, and some fabulous scores from Germany. It's a super start here for USA, Belgium and Germany. Too early to tell, Pete, who's going to come out on top, but we will know tonight.
It's been an exciting reigning, and we're really looking forward to tonight's event.
Well, Pete, thank you very much indeed for joining us. We hope we'll do some more with you over the next couple of days. We've got Tom McCutcheon, whose son has just hit the big time here in World Equestrian Games, doing the final half of this competition. And that just shows you that after three rounds of Italy and France, they're in front. But of course, United States and Germany still got a riders to come. That's the end of the first session. Thank you for joining us here.